wonderful world of Disney. Tonight, on the wonderful world of Disney, the Whiz Kid and the Carnival Caper.
We're in trouble now, Daph. Alvin's gonna be awful mad. Yeah. I told you we shouldn't have borrowed his stuff.
Maybe he didn't even have to know. Come on, let's see if we can get it.
So Billy says sister really liked to meet me, huh?
Boy, Alvin, why do you even waste your time thinking about girls? They're always getting in the way or messing things up.
She's a classic.
Oh, I don't know. She's not bad, but I wouldn't say
I mean that rocket dummy, not Billy's sister.
Hey, aren't those your colors, Alan? I thought you were the only one in town with orange and black.
Yeah, someone else has got the same shoe. Or else that is my chute.
Looks like it's gonna land over on Maple Street.
Come on, Shoie.
Just a couple more inches, Steph. I've got one foot on it.
Hey, Steffi!
Heads up, Daph. I gotta let you go.
Oh!
Hey, Steffi, where's Daffy?
Gee, I don't know, Alvin. Well, she was here just a minute ago.
Hey, Steph, what's going on? Who's up there?
It's me, Daffy. What are you doing down there?
Hi, Alvin.
Are you all right?
Yeah. These leaves and stuff are kind of stickery, but they're soft.
If Dad ever knew you were playing in the storm...
I'm not playing. I fell.
And what are you doing monkeying around with my rockets? I told you never.
Gosh, Alvin.
I was playing with your rockets. One of them went bananas and came down here. I tried to get it and I fell. And now I'm stuck down here and all I want to do is get out of here, Alvin.
Okay, Daph, okay. Just hold a second while I get my bearings. Look, Daph, it's a cinch. Just angle off to your right and go past two more curb drains. Then turn right for one short block and you'll come out right behind Mr. Blodgett's house. And we'll be there to meet you, okay?
Okay. And Alvin?
Yeah, Daph?
I got your rocket back.
Thanks, Daph.
Steffi, pick up all that stuff and drop it off at my house, will you?
You bet, Alvin.
Come on, Shoie. Daffy's kind of scared. We better go give her a hand.
See, what did I tell you? Women.
Thank you.
here. Damn,
hey,
holy,
slow
stop.
Down. Hold it.
What's the matter?
I'm in with a gun. I just saw a man with a gun.
Calm down, Daffy. It's all right now.
Honest, I did.
Sure, Daff. What was he doing in there, hunting frogs?
No, he was standing right next to me.
It's all right, Daff. We believe you.
Alvin, are we ever going to get to the carnival grounds or not?
Yeah, right now. Here we go. You too, Daff. It'll be fun.
But, Alvin, you gotta believe me. I saw this guy, and he had a gun. And he disappeared into thin air, just like that.
Boy, talk about cracking up. Cost a bundle.
The cost of sugar raises the price of cotton candy. But what raises the price of a Ferris wheel ride?
I don't know, but my $3.50 isn't going to go very far in there.
I got a little more than four.
I've got 75 cents.
It's just not enough. Well, I guess it's time to pull out the old quick moneymaker machine.
Oh, no. Not again, Alvin. That thing's nothing but trouble.
Look, I made a few adjustments since last time. It works great now.
That's what you said last time.
Come on, you'll see. We got work to do.
Boy, Alvin, it's twice as fast as it was before, but it sure got a lot heavier. Come on, Daff, help us out.
Daffy?
Huh? Oh, yeah. You know, I still can't figure out what some man with a gun would be sneaking
not
around.
Again, Daff. You've been talking about that all day. We've got work to do. How much do we have now, Alvin?
$6.50. Another two or three cars, and we ought to have plenty.
See? Now, come on, push. Somebody had moved into the old Matthews house.
Neither did I. Whoever did sure needs a car wash. Come on, let's go see.
Hey, Alvin. I just remembered something. Garfield Thatcher said he saw a ghost in there once.
I don't believe in ghosts.
Neither did Garfield Thatcher till I saw one. Oh, wait here.
Ghosts.
Get the buzzer.
Someone's coming.
Good afternoon. My associates and I, with the help of a brand new scientific car washing invention, are prepared to transform your automobile into one of the most beautiful things in the world.
Sounds great. How much is it?
Well, we usually charge about $1.50. Your car's pretty dirty.
Yeah, it really is, isn't it? Well, I just recently moved in and haven't had much time to get at it. Oh, I'm Cathy Martin.
I'm Alvin Fernald, and this is my friend Ben. I mean my best friend, Shoie. And this is my sister, Daffy. I'm her brother.
Shoie?
Pleased to meet you, ma'am.
Daffy?
Hi.
And Alvin? $2 be fair?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Wait right here, and I'll go in and get it.
Boy, Alvin, you really came unglued.
Do you feel sick?
Yeah, he's sick. Love sick.
No, no, no. What do you mean? Come on, we got work to do. Daffy, hook up the hose. And Shoie, start pulling the rack over the car.
Here you are, Alvin. $2. And thank you.
Thank you, Miss Martin. If there's anything else I can help you with, let me know.
I will. That's very nice of you. See you later.
I sure hope so.
Do you want more water this time, Alvin? Alvin?
What?
Do you want more water this time?
Yeah, that's a good idea, Dad.
What about the soap valve? Should we leave it the same?
No, let's turn it up and make this one an extra good job.
Why should we?
Yeah, Alvin. Mrs. Palin's car was much dirtier than this, and we didn't give her extra suds.
Because Miss Martin is paying more, so we should give her our super deluxe job. Now, come on, you two. Let's get at it. You ready, Daph?
Yeah, just a sec.
Stand by. Ready, Shoie?
Ready.
Engines.
Walt Disney Presents will be right back.
Thursday on Magical World of Disney. Get ready to get pumped up for Hercules. Go from zero to hero when you take off on Disney's 35th animated adventure featuring a monster cast.
Guys, Olympus would be that way.
A hotshot villain.
Two thumbs way, way up.
And one true hero.
Thank you, thank you.
So don't miss Disney's Hercules, followed by Mr. Magoo. Thursday on Magical World of Disney. Movies at 7, 6 Central.
Walt Disney is reliving the 70s. And what better way to celebrate the decade of disco than an online chat with one of Disney's favorite stars, Kim Richards. Kim was one of Disney's most recognizable child stars throughout the 70s, starring in classics like Escape to Witch Mountain and No Deposit, No Return.
It's rather easy once you catch on.
So tune in all week to see Kim Richards in her biggest Disney hits. And chat with Kim by going online at Disney.com. Tonight at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific.
Here's something you ought to know.
Every morning inside Walt Disney.
You're no fool, no siree.
Of course you're not a fool, because you know the Ink and Paint Club is the one place to find all your favorite Disney animated classics.
Oh, boy!
Like characters with a musical touch and a Midas touch. Handy pigs and acrobatic mice. Even crickets as smart as your biology teacher.
They're the smallest bones in your body.
So don't be a fool.
I'm no fool.
Watch the Ink and Paint Club every morning at 5 a.m. 4 Central inside Walt Disney.
Thursday on Magical World of Disney, it's your favorite man of mystery, Mr. Magoo. He's the master of disguise.
Mr. Peru is Mr. Magoo.
And an expert at uncovering clues, even when he doesn't have a clue.
No one escapes Magoo.
Okay, so he's not perfect. We still love him, and you'll fall for him, too.
Vanilla!
Hey, he's Mr. Magoo.
Magoo, you've done it again.
Catch Mr. Magoo right after Hercules. Thursday on Magical World of Disney, movies at 7, 6 Central.
And now, back to Walt Disney Presents, right here on Disney.
Oh, Alvin, you didn't have to do the insides, too.
Well, that's okay, Miss Martin. They were easy.
Sure looks great.
Thanks.
Well, I guess that just about does it. And I'm sorry again for all the trouble, Miss Martin.
Forget it. It was an accident.
May I help you with those?
All right, Alvin, you can. If you do me a favor first.
Sure, you name it, Miss Martin.
How about just calling me Kathy? Alvin? Alvin, is that all right with you?
Oh, sure, that'll be fine. Just fine. Kathy.
Okay. Dust those off and put them in those boxes. I'm trying to get a bit of color in this old house.
How long have you lived here?
7 or 8 weeks now.
Well, I guess I just didn't notice you moved in.
Well, I put in a full week at the bank, and then I've been out of town on the weekends.
Well, it's a little late, but welcome to Riverton, Kathy.
Thank you. It's nice to be here, Alvin.
Did you know there's a carnival opening tonight?
Yes, one of the girls at the bank mentioned it the other day.
Are you gonna go?
No.
I could take you.
Would
you like to go with me?
Yes, I would. I'd like that very much.
Great. I don't drive, but it's not far from here.
Well, I'll meet you there. 7:30. How about that?
Sure, that sounds just fine.
Would you like to bring your sister and Shoie along?
Well, I don't want to, but I'll bet they'll be there anyway.
Sounds fun.
Yeah.
Would you get the front door? Tell whoever it is I'll be right there. I'll get the back door.
Okay. Oh, hi, Shoie. Come on in.
Hi, Mrs. Fernald. Is Alvin home?
I was just helping Kathy with some housework. Did you and Daffy get the car washer back to the house okay?
Yeah, I helped Mr. Exley with the mail. And then Daffy went over and apologized.
But I got work to do.
I know, but he's just a boy. He's not going to get in your way.
What if I make a noise, Donnie? I don't want nobody snooping around. Do you understand? Now, you get rid of him.
All right. Go ahead and get started.
Well, do it, do it.
I'll get him to leave.
Was Mr. Exley mad?
Yeah, kinda. He couldn't stop sneezing. He said he was allergic to soap suds.
Hi, Shoie.
Hi, Miss Martin.
Look, boys, I'm afraid you're going to have to go now. My kid brother just got into town on leave, and he only has a short stay before he has to be back on base, so...
We understand. We should be going anyway.
Thanks a lot for all the help, Alvin. See you tonight at 7:30, right?
Right. See you then, Kathy. Come on, Shoie.
Her kid brother on Spider-Man.
What do you mean?
I saw him going to the bat, and he was dressed more like a plumber than a serviceman.
So, maybe Secret Service?
With a shovel and a toolbox?
Why would Kathy lie?
I don't know. Maybe. And when did it become Kathy? And what is this about you two meeting tonight?
I'm taking her to the carnival. We've got a date.
Do you know how much that's gonna cost you? Boy. Well, I'd keep a close eye on her if I were you.
I plan to.
No. I mean something fishy's going on here, Alvin. This is her house, and she...
Shoie, you're beginning to sound just like Daffy. Come on.
But... And another thing, he doesn't even look like her. He's short and dark, and she's kind of skinny and pale. kid brother my foot. He's old enough to be her father.
Complete my most daring experiment. Even now, my faithful servant Marco is about to unearth the last important ingredient. Tonight, we shall see our creature come to life. Now, I must make ready. Professor Dimitri will be very pleased with what I have done. The final elixir. The last link to his greatest creation.
Boy, what a rip-off. This monster better be something.
I am it, Master. The potion. Here it is.
Very good, my faithful servant. Once again, you have served me well. And now, I must go into the electrodrome. Now the moment has finally arrived when I, Professor Vladimir Dimitrich, will make you come to life. Him live! Live!
Yeah.
flights he fell again.
35 cents a piece. Boy, did they see us coming.
Come on, let's get him out of the way.
Abner, this is the third time this month this has happened. I'm not going to put up with this anymore.
Look, I'll work all through the night, Bernie. I can put them back together. I know I can.
You'd better. If you haven't got this pile of nuts and bolts back in shape by tomorrow night, you better start looking for another job. I'm sorry, folks, but there's plenty of thrills and excitement out on the Midway.
Just step outside and I'll show you...
You clean up backstage, Hank. I'll take care of everything out here, okay? Are you kids all right? I mean, anybody get hurt?
Oh, no, sir. We're fine, but this broke off.
Oh, dear. I'm afraid my wangdoodle friend here and I are getting a little too old.
What is a wangadoodle?
Oh, just an imaginary creature. An undefined body. But a body that needs to be repaired somehow.
Did you build him, sir?
No, I bought him about 8 or 9 years ago. I guess he's just wearing out.
I bet you Alvin could fix him.
Who?
Oh, I'm Alvin, sir. Alvin Fernald. This is my sister Daffy, and this is Shoie.
Alvin? Shoie?
My real name's Daphne, Professor.
Daphne? My, what a romantic name. I'm very pleased to make your acquaintance, Miss Daphne. I am Professor Dimitrik, also known as Abner Debney, at your command.
Wow!
You know, if you'd lower the air pressure and add a two-way slide belt, I'll bet you can make something like this walk.
Say, you sound like you know a little bit about monster making.
Oh, he's great. He's invented all kinds of mechanical stuff.
He has?
Yeah, and I call him Alvin Magnificent.
Oh, really? Well, Mr. Magnificent, what do you think? Alvin? You all right?
Oh, he's just in one of his trances, Mr. Debney.
That's how he does his thinking.
Oh.
I've got it. Mr. Debney, would you let me use my robot in place of your monster? It's battery-powered with a Wilson audio circuit, and it's totally remote-controlled by 27...
Whoa, slow down. You have a robot?
He sure does.
And he made it himself.
And it really works. It needs a few adjustments, but with your costume and mask, he could be a brand-new wangdoodle monster.
Well, I don't know, Alvin. It sounds... I tell you what. Why don't you bring him by tomorrow? Let me see him, okay?
Yes, sir.
Good. Oh, and get permission from your parents. If he works. What do you say if I give you $10 a day, okay?
You bet.
You got a deal, Mr. Debney. Thanks a lot.
Sure.
Oh, no, I almost forgotten about meeting Cathy. We gotta go, Mr. Debney. We'll see you tomorrow.
Bye, Alvin.
Bye.
Bye, Shoie.
Bye.
Bye, Daphne.
Stay tuned. Walt Disney Presents will be right back.
Running out of stuff to do on your summer vacation? Is boredom getting you down? Well, this summer, try these ideas from Milo and Otis to kick the summertime blues. You can learn to fish, try a new water sport, or take an afternoon swim, take up gardening, or how about taking a swing at bird watching? For more of Milo and Otis's summertime tips, don't miss The Adventures of Milo and Otis, followed by Disney's Young Musician Symphony Orchestra in concert, tonight on Magical World of Disney at 7, 6 Central.
And now, a Disney moment from inside Walt Disney.
Our latest and greatest dream. That's it, right here. Disneyland, seen from about 2,000 feet in the air and 10 months away.
Shooting out from here, like the four cardinal points of the compass, Disneyland is divided into four cardinal realms. Adventureland, Tomorrowland, Fantasyland, and Frontierland.
Ronnie Reagan will take it away for the dedication ceremonies to Disneyland. All activity on Main Street has ceased. And now, Walt Disney will step forward to read the dedication of Disneyland.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideals, the dreams, and the hard facts that have created America, with the hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to all the world.
Watch for the Disneyland story this month inside Walt Disney. And now, back to Walt Disney Presents, right here on Disney.
Things to do at home. Do you need a ride?
No, thanks. We'll walk. We just live down the street and we don't have to be in till 10.
Oh, well, you can use these extra tickets.
Thanks.
I really enjoyed tonight. It was fun. And Alvin, thanks a lot. It was a lovely date. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Let's go to Zip.
No, the Ferris wheel.
We did that one.
Find out something about him.
And her. Hey, Dad, watch this.
Big deal. Where have you been?
I had to mow the lawn and pick up some stuff for my mom. What are you doing out here?
Alvin doesn't want anybody to see until he's finished.
That doesn't mean me, Daphne.
He said he didn't want anybody to see. And that means you, too.
Does not.
Does so.
Does not.
Ready, Daph.
See, I told you so.
Shoe? Huh? Bend over.
Thanks, Daph.
Where is he, Alvin?
To do on him.
You did a great job on the shoes.
Thanks, Shoie. They had a little more height to him that way. And the rest was just a matter of changing the controls around a little bit.
I bet you he's 8 feet tall.
And with Mr. Debney's stuff, he'll be the scariest wang doodle monster ever.
Come on, Shoie. Let's finish him up and get him over to the carnival.
Show. You keep them packed in.
These youngsters really came through for me, didn't they?
I don't care where it came from. You just make sure we keep it.
Alvin, monster's making quite a hit out there.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Debney!
What's the matter?
Something went wrong.
We gotta stop him!
He's going outside. Come on!
For centuries, thought to be dead and buried in the mysterious...
Wiped out my whole act here, Bernie.
I'm awful sorry, Mr. Debney. You just short-circuited. We'll help clean up.
You bet you will. And when I get a final accounting, you're gonna pay for it all, too.
Don't worry about it, Bernie. I'll take care of it.
That thing could put me out of business. Come on, kids. Give me a hand.
You sure did make a mess, Alvin.
Yeah, maybe you and Shoie better go clean that up.
Oh, that's okay, kid. I'll get some of the roughies to do it.
What can we do to help, Mr. Debney?
Well, about the most important thing right now is to get our star attraction here back in order.
Looks like the wiring system is the only thing broken.
Oh, boy. Think you can get it working again by tomorrow?
Yes, sir, I think so.
Good. I'll tell you what, I'll get somebody to help you move them.
Don't you worry about it, kids. I mean, it's just an accident. It really looks worse than it is.
Will you need some help with him at home?
No, thanks, Shoie. Once we get him to the workshop, Daffy and I can do it.
Then I think I'll do a little snooping around like we said.
Hey, I forgot all about that.
Well, I didn't. While you two are in Benton, I'll handle the investigating. See you later.
You all right?
Yeah. I wish you'd get rid of this thing, Alvin. The only one it works on is me. How you going here?
We're almost done. Just gotta close them up.
Hey, guess what I found out?
What?
That guy we were gonna watch, he works for the magician at the carnival.
You're kidding.
Nope. And I just saw him both sneaking something in the back door at Miss Martin's house.
Yeah? What was it?
It looked like some kind of big heavy box.
Magician guy is over at Kathy's house? Wonder what he's doing there. She can't like him.
I don't know, but, we should go over there and do a little snooping around, don't you think?
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right, Shoie. I'll just get my extendable reach all multi-purpose boom mic, in case we need it.
Wait a minute. Didn't we use this thing once before?
No, that was an old model. We'll see what this one can do.
I hope it worked better than the last time. Let's go the back way, Alvin, just in case you know who's snooping around.
Okay, it's shorter anyway.
Something.
Well, I couldn't find an open window, so we're gonna have to adjust for overhead.
What does that mean?
I'll explain. It means you're gonna take this boom mic and climb up higher.
How come I always get the tough part? I don't wanna climb any higher.
Hey, Alvin, I will.
Oh, no. How do you always know where we are?
Hi. Hi.
Shh. What are you doing here?
I came to help you. I'll climb up higher, Alvin.
No, you won't. All right, Alvin, what do you want me to do?
Just climb up to the highest branch and extend the pole until it reaches the chimney. Then feed out the line and lower the mic down into the fireplace in the living room.
Then what?
Then just drop the extension. Daph and I will plug in down here so we can hear. Now go on.
Sure. I do all the work and you get to listen. It just ain't fair. I gotta lug this 50-pound fishing pole up this tree while you have all the fun down there. How come I always get the dirty jobs?
Now, when I get to the bank at 10, you'll be there, huh?
Yes, I'll be there.
And you'll be at the right window?
Yes. Don't worry about me. I've done my part so far, haven't I?
Yeah, you've done great. And if we all just stay cool, this thing will come off like clockwork.
You know, Vince?
Mm-hmm.
I've been thinking. Maybe you and Birdbrain here can handle this without me. Why don't I just meet you at the airport?
Oh, no way, sweetheart. Not now. We need you at the bank tomorrow. And besides, you're up to your pretty little neck in this. Just like we are.
Yeah, just one big happy family.
Thank you.
Prince, I gotta hand it to you. This is some sweet deal.
Yeah, thanks. I've waited a long time for this one.
Yeah, when we robbed that bank tomorrow, the Hicks and his little burg won't know what hit him. And then it's Acapulco all the way.
And I don't want to see another rabbit in a hat as long as I live.
Whoa. Hey, you and your rabbits. Hey, what's in the fireplace?
Quick, Shoie, pull it back, fast!
Didn't you see that?
Huh?
Vince, I think there might be something on the roof.
Oh, yeah?
Let's go take a look. They're coming out. Take this and hide over there. Freeze, Shoie, just freeze!
See anything, Ernie?
No, but I'm sure hearing funny noises.
It's probably just a cat. Come on, we gotta get back for the 9 o'clock show.
I don't know, Vince. Maybe we ought to look
around.
Come on,
will you? Your nerves are just a little edgy.
Shoie, we gotta get going.
Where are we going, Alvin?
To the police station to tell Captain Moody.
Captain Moody? Why are we going to the police station?
To tell him about the bank robbery tomorrow.
Bank robbery? What bank robbery?
The magician, that other guy. Weren't you listening? Come on.
Yeah, I was listening, but I didn't hear anything. Hey,